Hello friends, welcome to this video on circles. So far, we learnt about circle and its related terms, and we also discussed some theorems related to it. In this video, we will study about circle through 3 points. According to the definition, a circle is a collection of all the points in a plane which are equidistant from a fixed point in the plane, and there are infinite points on the circle. But have you ever thought how many points will be enough to draw a circle? 1, 2, 3, 4 or many points? Let's discuss this. Let's understand this through an activity. Let us start with a point. Let's say circles passing through point A. Now, take some metal rings that are circular and of different measurement, that is, their radii should be different. In how many ways can you place these metal rings on point A? We can place them like this. We can also place them like this. You can see that we can put these rings on the point in as many ways as the number of rings present. So friends, how many different circles can we draw passing through point A? If we draw circles using a compass, we'll find that infinite circles passing through point A can be drawn. Friends, instead of one point, if we take 2 points, point B and point C, then how many circles can you draw passing through them? You can place the rings of different sizes in this manner, keeping in mind the distance between 2 points. You can also place the rings in this way. Thus, you can place the rings in many ways. That is, we can draw infinite circles passing through 2 points with the help of a compass. We draw the first circle, second circle, and this one is the third circle. We can draw more circles by taking different radii. Let's move forward and look at the number of circles that can pass through 3 points. If all 3 points are in the same line, then in this case, these points are called collinear points. D, E and F are collinear points. Let us see in how many ways we can place the rings on these 3 points. Is there a ring that will pass through all these 3 points? No. There is no ring that will pass through all these 3 collinear points. With the help of a compass, can you draw a circle passing through these 3 collinear points D, E and F? You can try to draw a circle by pausing the video. No, because if we draw circles passing through points D and E, then point F is getting left out. If we draw a circle with E and F, then point D is getting left out. And if we take points D and F, then point E comes in the middle of the circle. You can see that the third point will always be either inside or outside the circle, passing through 2 points. Therefore, we cannot draw a single circle passing through 3 collinear points. Now if we take the 3 points G, H and I in such a way that they are not in the same line, then we call these points as non-collinear points. Now we will try to place the rings on G, H and I. Is there a ring that will pass through all these 3 points? Let's see. friends, here you can only get the ring with one radius that will pass through these three points G, H and I. So, can we say that we can draw one and only one circle passing through three non-collinear points? Let's check. Can we draw more circles from these points? No. We can only draw one circle passing through these three non-collinear points. Let us see the mathematical proof for this. First, let's join GH and HI this way. And draw perpendicular bisectors of GH and HI, that is PQ and RS respectively. Which intersect each other at point O. We know that each point of the perpendicular bisector of a line segment is equidistant from its end points. Point O is located on perpendicular bisector PQ of line segment GH. That is why OG and OH are equal. Similarly, OH and OI will also be equal. Therefore, we can say that OG is equal to OH is equal to OI, which means that points GH and I are at the same distance from the point O. So, if we draw a circle by assuming point O as the center and OG as the radius, then it will also pass through OH and OI. And this is a unique circle. That is, we cannot draw any circle other than this that will pass through these three non-collinear points. Thus, we have proved that we can draw one and only one circle passing through the given three non-collinear points. With this, we learned that three non-collinear points are sufficient to draw one circle. You can repeat this activity with your classmates. Let's meet in the next video with similar questions based on this. Thank you.